Now I'm going to move on to textbook chapter 2.5, which is mechanical forms of work. Yeah, so we're going to go into mechanical forms of work. So we have few works here, which is the shaft work, the spring work, work done by elastic solid bar, work associated with stretching of liquid film, and work done to raise or to accelerate a body. So we're going to study all this work. Yeah, so there are two requirements for a work interaction between system and surroundings. There must be a force acting on the boundary. So the first criteria is there must be a force acting on the boundary. The second would be the boundary must move. So let's look at it. The first work, force times distance. Yeah, force times distance, where you have a box, yeah, like a box, something like this, moving. And the distance must be parallel distance. Yeah, parallel distance, remember? Yeah, we have work equals to force times distance. There are two types. One is parallel, one is perpendicular. The parallel one will give you work, like what you are doing now here. The perpendicular one will give you what? Torque. Remember what you studied in your physics? Force times distance as well, but this distance is perpendicular. It's not parallel. Okay, so let's come back to only parallel distance. We're going to analyze parallel distance here. So what we have here is work equals to force times distance. Now, at some cases, you may not have some constant value, okay, which is not constant. Yeah, so we have ds, so integration from point 1 to point 2. Okay, so the work is proportional to the force applied and the distance traveled. So work equals to force times distance. So let's look at shaft work, one of the form of the work. Shaft work is given by force times distance as well, but what is the force? So you have torque, which is force times with the distance. Remember what I told you just now, rotation, because of rotation. So force is equals to torque divided by r is the movement at the arm or the perpendicular distance. Okay, so since s is actually 2 pi r, you see, when you are rotating in a circular motion, yeah, it is 2 pi r, right? 2 pi multiplied with r. Okay, so you plug in all the values inside, so you're generating work shaft is actually equivalent to 2 pi n is the number of rotation and t is the torque. So you want to calculate the power, you just have to take this value and divide by time, settle. So that is the shaft work. It is not too common in thermo class, but anyway, you need to know. Yeah, okay, so let's move on next to spring work. This is very common. Yeah, you know spring work, right? Half k x extension 2 minus with extension 1, square, yeah? Both are square. Okay, now okay, so when the length of spring changes by a difference and under amount of dx, the influence, the work of force F, work done is F dx. For linear elastic springs, the displacement x is proportional to the spring, to the force applied. So F equals to kx. So this is the force and this is the work. Okay, so we're done with this. That is the second type. Now the third and the fourth is not common. Yeah, a work done on the elastic solid bar is not common, but you just need to know. Yeah, this is the formula for it. And work associated in stretching of a liquid film is also not common, and this is the formula. Okay, so we are done with this. Next is to raise and accelerate a body. Work transfer needs to raise a body is equal to the change in potential energy of the body. The work transfer needed to accelerate the body is equal to the change in kinetic. You remember your mgh and your mv square, half mv square. Yeah, this is the formulas for that. Yeah, and there are non-mechanical forms of work. Yeah, all those that I've discussed just now is the mechanical form. We have non-mechanical form, which is electrical work, magnetic work, electric polarization work. Yeah, so which are not too common in thermo in our syllabus, but anyway, you need to know as well. Okay, we're going to move on to power needs of a car to climb a hill, which is example 2.8 from the textbook. So consider a 1200 kilogram car cruising steadily at 90 kilometers per hour. Now the car starts climbing at the hill at a slope of 13 30 degrees from the horizontal. If the velocity of the car is to remain constant during climbing, determine the additional power that must be delivered by the engine. Okay, so what we have here? Okay, a car solution, and let's look at the solution. A car is to climb a hill while maintaining a constant velocity. The additional power needed is to be determined. So the analysis would be the additional power required in simply the work that needs to be done per unit time raised the elevation car, which is equal to the change of potential energy. So potential energy is actually mgh, so mass of the car m, and we have the g and the h. You see the height, yeah, so this is where we need to actually convert. So we have the speed, which is 90 kilometer per hour and sine 30. Okay, maybe we should refer to the diagram of the question. Yeah, and I'm going to look for the diagram of the question so it's easier for us to visualize. Yeah, we just want example 2.8. Yeah, okay, that's how it is. Okay, so what we have here is we have a slope of 30 and we have 90 kilometers per hour. So when you multiply these, this actually is actually converting you to the height. Yeah, height. Why do you take sine 30? Because we want the vertical height. The vertical height. Yeah, mgh. H is the vertical height. So this is the conversion. Yeah, this part is the conversion. This is the conversion. 1 meter per second to kilometer per hour. We just want to cancel off. Yeah. So at the end of the day, you will get 147 kilojoule per second. Yeah. So with this, this is the end of this chapter. So we'll meet again in the next chapter. Thank you. Yeah.